only people that are the boss of me right now are you. You, the people of Markham Stouffville, you're the boss of me.
Jane Philpott was a star of the Liberal cabinet since she got elected in 2015, serving as Ministers of Health, Indigenous Affairs and Treasury Board President. In March, she resigned from cabinet as part of the very public disagreement over the SNC-Lavalin file, before being thrown out of the Liberal caucus entirely. And as you heard earlier today, the MP for Markham Stouffville ended weeks of speculation, announcing that she will seek re-election in October as an independent. And Jane Philpott joins me here in studio tonight. Nice to see you.
Nice to be here.
Thanks for making the time. In what way did belonging to a political party limit you in some way, either as an MP or a minister?
Well, there is no question that parties have their purpose. Obviously, it's great to be able to organize with others, to be able to have the structure of a party, to draw in a lot of people on building policy. So I certainly don't think that parties in and of themselves are problematic. I do think the party discipline and power has, in some cases, gone beyond what is in the best interest of Canadians when it is, for instance, the party or unelected political staff that are dictating everything that ministers say and even that MPs say, dictating how people vote. And that's the part that I think Canadians are concerned about.
Can you give me an example of that, though? Because you're a strong, smart person. It might be difficult for people to believe that a staffer told you what to say and what to do and that you just did it.
Well, you're absolutely right. I didn't always do what I was told, but certainly every single minister is given lines to to repeat or to put forward. And that's, again, not necessarily a bad thing. But when you have, for instance, every single vote in the House of Commons, when parties are literally a sheet of paper put on every member of Parliament's desk dictating how those members of Parliament will vote, it gives you pause to think who's in charge. And who should be in charge is the people of Canada, our constituents. And so that some of those things are concerning, and there's a certain amount of freedom to being independent.
Right, but that's not really true, that MPs have to vote however they're dictated. And I would point you to that genetic discrimination bill that the Prime Minister and your friend Jody Wilson-Raybould said, you have to vote this way. And in fact, more than 100 Liberal MPs stood up and voted the other way, the way that their leader didn't want them to. So I'm not sure how much truth there is to what you're saying. Are you saying that MPs just follow blindly leaders'
I certainly wouldn't want to suggest that that MPs necessarily follow blindly, and I think that's a great thing when there is that freedom and flexibility, and certainly that is there in some cases. But there is a strong pressure to toe the party line, to not necessarily go against the party on a particular piece of legislation.
Your position, though, the reason you're getting attention today and other days since all of this started is because you bought into that party ideal. I mean, that's what's elevated you to this status. So do you recognize the importance of that? That you wouldn't, if you were just independent Jane Philpott right now, we probably wouldn't be doing an interview.
I totally accept what you're saying. I didn't want to be in this position. I didn't expect to be in this position that I'm in. So this is a reality that I had to face. I had hoped when I stepped down from cabinet that I would be able to stay in the Liberal caucus, and that wasn't possible. So now I had a decision to make about going forward, and I believe that I still have a role to play in federal politics. It will be up to the people of Markham Stouffville to decide for sure, but I want to present myself as an option if people believe that I can represent them best.
You know that your riding, it has been conservative. You won by, I think, close to 4,000 votes. Are you worried about splitting the vote and ending up with conservatives representing your riding? And I don't think you're strongly aligned with the conservatives on many issues.
No, I am running because I hope that I will win. I acknowledge that it's going to be challenging. This is not something that we have a big model for here in Canada. I hope that people will look to this and say, yes, this is a good thing. We could do with more independent
MPs. You do realize that sounds a bit utopian, though. The system, the electoral system, is not set up for this. The Westminster parliamentary system is not set up for this. There's a reason we have parties.
Well, there is a reason that we have parties, but I would argue with you that Canada is one of the countries that have a parliamentary democracy that is the least friendly to independence to date. But I believe that there are many opportunities to have a voice. I can speak on many occasions in the House. I can speak to the public and certainly push and work with others.
Could you be a Liberal if there was a different leader?
At the moment, it's not an option for me, so it was a decision that was taken out of my hands, and I will move forward and do the best to serve the people of my community.
Okay. Jane Philpott, thanks for coming in
tonight. Thanks for having
me.
Appreciate
it. Nice to see you.